You. My YouTube channel, my name is Nobuhle, and on today's episode we will be talking about the cost of living, or how much you should be getting paid according to where you are being employed. I live in Chiang Rai, which is the north of Thailand, and I have made a video about the cost of living in Thailand. Now, a lot of you asked me on my Instagram, why did I say 30,000 baht? 30,000 baht is not the standard pay that you get paid. 30,000 baht was actually an example. But it's only enough if you are living in the north. However, if you're living outside of the north, I'm gonna ask you to ask for a little bit more, because the cost of living in those other provinces is much, much higher than in the north. Now, the reason why, I think I've mentioned this in my previous video about the north not being a touristy place, it's more of a local place, right? While the south is more of a touristy place. Because when everybody thinks about Thailand, they think about Phuket, they think about Bangkok, they think about, you know, Koh Samui, they think about all those other southern islands compared to the mountainous area, which is the north. Some people have never even heard of Chiang Rai. Well, if you want to know more about Chiang Rai, just go down to my other videos. Okay, so this video is not about the north. I did a video about the north. If you want to know more about the cost of living there, you can check out the video down below. Now, I am going to talk about the south. Oh my goodness. The south is super expensive, with rent rate ranging from 6,500 to 10,000 even, right? It depends on the kind of area, the kind of condo you want to choose for yourself. But the good side about living in the north is that the schools may offer you accommodation where you will be living in or within the school's borders or within the school gates. But you know, as an adult, it's really not advisable to live within the borders of your school, because you know you won't be able to move freely like you're supposed to, especially because COVID is still an issue. Yes. Thailand still takes COVID very seriously. People here still wear masks. I have to wear masks whenever I am in class or teaching the kids. So COVID is still an issue. So you living within the school premises is going to be quite tricky, especially if you are, you know, used to living by yourself and at your own terms, or in your own terms. Ooh. Okay, so I hardly ever do the sit downs, so this is quite tricky for me. Another thing is that when it comes to transportation in Bangkok, it's easier to get around compared to the north, right? In the north, you do need to hire yourself a bike, you know, in order to get around. You can't really get quick transportation, especially in Maasai. I mean, there were times when I got here, I didn't know how to ride a bike and I couldn't even risk it. So I was using Grab. Grab is an app like Uber, but not really. So I was using Grab to get around until I got stuck at 9 p.m. at a supermarket and I couldn't get any Grab. Oh my gosh, thank you to a good Samaritan. There are so many of those here who helped me get home. But that day made me realize that, ooh, I need to actually, you know, put on my big girl panties and just learn how to ride a bike, because honey, it was hard. But when you are in the south, it's easier for you to get around using taxis rather than you getting a bike, because a lot of reckless drivers are on the road and you might get into trouble. I've been in an accident before here in Thailand, and as a foreigner, I don't think you'll have the greatest or any pleasant, you know, experience with that. So I would highly recommend you to use transportation, which is public. Your buses, your metro rails, you know, everything's just convenient and very easy to get around and explore the city. However, it can be quite expensive, especially if you don't know how to get around or you don't have a Thai friend who is there to help you. Now, if you don't know how to get around or you just arrived in Thailand and you are stuck in a tuk-tuk and you're just getting scammed left and right. Now, as a person who's been scammed before, I'm here to give you tips so that you don't become me. Okay. So now back to jobs. If you're getting a job in Bangkok and a school is hiring you and they're offering you 30,000 baht, just know they're exploiting you. They are really exploiting you. 30,000 baht is not enough to live in the south. It's not enough. In fact, even 35,000 baht is not enough. You need a lot to survive in the south, okay? Even the street food there is super expensive. So at least maybe start at 45,000 baht, right? Also, listen, ask for 45 or more. Don't ask for anything less, because if you do ask for anything less, you aren't going to be able to survive and save, right? Because remember, as a foreign teacher, you don't really have other... Ooh, it's very loud. Okay, guys, so apps that you need to get around are... You need Grab. Definitely need Grab to get around Thailand. And I mentioned that. Anywhere in Thailand, you can obviously get Grab. Grab bike, Grab car, Just Grab, SUV, all of that. You name it, you can get it. So Grab is one of my favorites when it comes to local transportation to get around. Now, if I need to travel to another province or maybe I need to go to an island and I need to get myself a flight ticket, then I choose to always use Traveloka or Asia Air. Now, you need to download both apps because you have to compare. I always believe that when it comes to traveling, comparison is your best friend, okay? You need to compare both sites to see where you get the cheapest or most affordable air ticket. So flying around in Thailand is much cheaper. I love it. It's my favorite thing to do. So the apps that we mentioned when it comes to transportation and travel are Traveloka, Grab, and Asia Air. So those three apps you can use to get around Thailand. Now, if you need to order food, the apps that we have covered are Grab and Food Panda. Those two apps for me are the best. There is an app called Lion Man, but it's not available everywhere and it's predominantly in Thai. I don't think it uses English, so I wouldn't recommend you getting Line app because there's no English option. And then we have 7-Eleven app. 7-Eleven app can be useful sometimes if you're lazy, but 7-Eleven is always a walk away. So take a walk, honey. Okay, great. And then when it comes to accommodation, the apps that I like to use, I love using Hostel World, Agoda, bookings.com. bookings.com, you can never go wrong. Always have those three apps, because why? Comparison is your best friend when it comes to traveling. Agoda can be expensive sometimes, bookings can be expensive sometimes, and Hostel World can be expensive sometimes. So it's best for you to have all three apps in order for you to compare the prices and choose a place or a price that is suitable for you. So Hostel World, Agoda, and bookings.com, those three sites I highly recommend, because I've personally used them all three. I still use them three, so yes. And then let's get to other apps that you need to make your life easier in Thailand. Now, when it comes to shopping, a lot of people don't know, and I'm actually surprised. Well, I'm not surprised, because when I got here, I didn't even know where to get clothes, because I was like, oh my goodness, you know, everything's just super tight and just super weird. It's not my style, so what am I gonna do? And then somebody was like, why don't you just order from Shein? And I was like, Shein? Really? So yes, Shein, Shopee, and Lazada are your apps that you need to use in order for you to get your favorite items, honey. This one right here, I didn't get from Shein. I got it from Tesco's. So Tesco is a supermarket, or is it an all-purpose store? I don't know. It's sort of like Walmart and your Macros, right? So you can get your food, your supplies, as well as your clothes. So I got this from Tesco's, which is super cute. I love it. I love it. I know my mom's gonna love it. It's like sort of like her style. So I wear this when I, you know, I just love it. And then Lazada, you can order a bunch of stuff on Lazada. It's an e-commerce app, so there are different kinds of stores and it's very reliable. I've ordered from them before and everything that I've ordered, I have received, and everything that I didn't like, I've taken back and I've received my refund. Shopee as well as an e-commerce, so there are different stores there, you know, amazing, love it. Everything is, some things can be secondhand, some things are just, listen, Shopee will be your best friend. Shopee, Lazada, Shein, those three apps will be your best friend, okay? You need whatever you need, everything that you need, honey, everything that you need, especially if you are an online addict. I'm not one, but just in case I become one. Okay, so another app that you need on your phone is Line app, because a lot of Thai people use Line. Even your school might use Line to communicate with you. So Line is very important. You need to get Line, and maybe your WhatsApp and your iMessage are things that you can use to communicate with people from home. But as far as workplace and everywhere else, Line is your best friend. So yeah, Line is what you need in order for you to communicate with your kids, with the parents, with the school. So Line, get Line app immediately when you fly out. And the greatest thing, or not the greatest, but the it's not the greatest, well, the it's great that, but it's great, yeah, it is great, it's great that you can download Line even if you're in South Africa, because I downloaded Line when I was back home to communicate with my new employers and it worked. I used my mother's phone number that she lost, so I don't know if I leave Thailand and I don't know how I'm gonna keep the Line app, because I no longer have the number that I used to open an account. You know what, that's a story for another day. Let's move on, ciao. Okay guys, so we are almost at the end of our video. So one of the apps that you need in order for you to send money, you can use apps like Western Union, Zoom, Wise, or your bank transfers. Personally, I have been using Western Union for the past 2 years and I've been super happy with the services because I haven't had any problems really. So Western Union, I highly recommend. With other apps, I don't have experience, so I'm not really the best person to recommend other apps because I haven't used them. I tried using Wise in Thailand, but it was giving me problems, you know, because I know that everywhere else is the best app to used in order to send money. But in Thailand, I highly recommend Western Union because their agents are also available everywhere in the country. You know, your Big C, you can find a Western Union agent, you know, your supermarkets, your malls, and all of that. Okay, let's do a recap on the video. What did we cover? We covered that if you want to come to Thailand and you want to live in the south, then don't take anything less than 45,000 baht, because the south is super expensive, and if you do take less, you're going to be exploited and you're not going to enjoy your experience. You're going to be working from hand to mouth, okay? And we don't want that. We also covered the apps that you need to get around. We spoke about Grab, we spoke about Traveloka, the apps that you need to get food. We spoke about Food Panda. Everything else will be listed down below. Another thing, guys, I would really appreciate it if you comment any questions that you have down at the comment section, because you know what? I mean, I have to know what other questions that you need to know, you need answered, because if you're asking me a question, it's possible that there's somebody else who's curious and who wants to know the very same question that you're asking, you know. So the best thing to do is to always comment down below. Another thing, thank you so much for following me on Instagram, and I appreciate it. I appreciate your likes as well. I spoke for 2 minutes and without breathing. Amazing.